the post. That might have sealed the deal for Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
The post, Hedberg's friend. Let's see if that's the unseen hand as it was Thursday night. Another one thrown in front, and this time they score. Hedberg reached out, tried to cover up, and it's a 5-1 game in favor of Carolina.
Well, Devils, I've never seen them, Steve, be as vulnerable down low just outside the crease as we've seen here in a while. Now, there's the second one. That was after the Hurricane swarmed and hit the pipe, and the Devils think, okay, we're going to get through this thing. And just as Hedberg starts to put his stick down on the ice, is that Skinner? Look at that. It is. Oh! He hit it with the forehand, kept the stick there. We got to look at that if we can again. And he touched it a second time with the toe of his stick. What a great third effort.
His ninth goal of the season. And I know a lot of fans in New Jersey didn't see this coming tonight. Devils coming off a big finish on Thursday, battling back from two down to win in a shootout, and now down 5-1 here late in the second period. Mark Fain into the corner to pick this up for New Jersey. Pope free. And Pope checked away by Andy Green. Kostopoulos tries to clear it out of the zone, could not, and Green will skate at the center for the Devils. Just over 2 minutes remaining in the period. Ryan Carter played it across for the cutting Kostopoulos. Taken away by the Hurricanes, and Jamie McBain skates it away and dumps in. Full change for Carolina. This is the period of the long change. Now let's see what Green does. The long pass for Stephane Matteau, who sends it in deep. Bernier behind the Hurricanes net.
Carolina Hurricanes goal scored by
Stephane Matteau. Has Harrison on his back. Gives here to Travis Zajac in the corner. The puck work free by Nash and played ahead to Terry. Skinner from Jordan Staal and Tim Gleason at 17:15 to extend the Carolina lead. It's all Hurricanes now. Matteau deep in the Kane zone. Puck comes loose. Stephane Matteau tried to work it back to the point. Comes here to Balchenkov. His shot blocked away by Patrick Dwyer. Hammered out to center by Carolina. Final minute of the period as Falk plays this across for Harrison. Terry, pass for his former AHL linemate Nash, who dumps in. Here's Ponikarovsky for the Devils, looking to create something before the second period comes to an end. Crashing into the zone is Loktionov, able to pick up the loose puck. He's hit by Gleason. Kovalchuk, centering try, looking for Ponikarovsky. Back to the point, Zidlitsky with a drive, and he hammered one wide. Green with the sharp angle try. Ellis steers that aside. Now Kovalchuk. Flurry by the Devils with 25 seconds left in the period. Loktionov. Kovalchuk dives to keep it alive. Green able to hold the zone for only so long, and now played across to Loktionov. Here's Eliash with 8 seconds remaining. Backhand try off a skate in front, taken away by Corvo, and that will do it. Three unanswered goals by Carolina in the second period as the first 40 minutes go into the books.
And Pete DeBoer, I'm sure, is shocked after a pretty good first period, the way his team played, Steve, in the second. So many breakdowns and wide open chances against Hedberg. And it's a theme that you want to nip in the bud. They thought they had it under control after the last game, but it's reared its ugly head again tonight.
Shots on goal, 23 for the Devils, 18 for Carolina. Five have gotten by Hedberg. College kids, take a much-needed study break and come to the Rock for college night. Get a seat for $20 or upgrade to the ticket and food package to receive a voucher for a hot dog or pretzel and soda for $35. Head over to NewJerseyDevils.com/college to choose. See the Devils take on the Winnipeg Jets tomorrow night, or to be here when the Islanders visit on April 1st. That's college night, March 10th and April 1st. Coming up next, we go to the MSG studios and Hockey Night Live for an update from New York City. 5-1 Carolina leading the Devils here in Raleigh.